Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. I am back with another grocery haul. It is Wednesday afternoon, just after 1 p.m. Before we get started, I have to go ahead and say, if there's any loud noises or any craziness, Cohen and Aniston are home right now. Their school had a power outage and the AC went out, so I had to pick them up at like 11:45. So they're upstairs playing, they should be good to go. So if you hear anything, that's what it is. I like to usually do these when the kids are not home because it's just easier to film YouTube videos when you have like a quiet house. But all of this was $164.54, I believe. I had one out of stock item, which was just nectarine, so not a big deal. A couple substitutions. They were all fine except for bagels. I ordered mini size and they were substituting them with regular size. I wanted them for school lunches to make little mini bagel sandwiches and like little tiny bagel pizzas. So I should have just done like the regular size ones, but I was like, oh, those are huge. And yeah, so anyways, I just didn't do them. So when I go to Aldi again, I'll just grab the little mini ones that I get there. So let's start down here. We always start down here at this end. This is a larger haul. I like to budget like $150 for the week. Like I said, I spent $164.54. Usually I'm under budget, so it's not a big deal that I came in a little over budget. I'm hoping to make it to Sam's or Costco this week. That probably won't be a very large haul. Now I say that in hopes that I won't spend a ton of money. I need like toilet paper, snacks, like lunch meat, like some odds and ends and kind of some staples. But it seems like every time I go to one of those stores, I always spend more than I anticipated. So who knows? I don't even know if I'll be able to get it done this week. I was hoping to go tomorrow, but I might have to help my mom with a couple errands before she goes out of town. She leaves Saturday to go stay with my brother in Oregon for like 4 to 5 weeks. So Sam's Club or Costco might have to come early next week. So we're gonna start down here. We ordered some off. The mosquitoes have been absolutely insane around here because we've had a lot of monsoons and rain, so that's brought out all the mosquitoes. So baseball practice, it's been a nightmare. The kids can't even like play in the backyard without being like eaten alive by mosquitoes. So I ordered some off because I do have some. Let me see if I have some in here to show you guys the kind I know. Oh, that's not even it, that's a different brand. And they didn't have it, so they substituted it with this, which was fine because it was the same size and it was a lot cheaper, so we'll give this a shot. I ordered mini chippers. The kids absolutely love these. One thing I like about these are they are made in like a nut-free facility, so they are school friendly. Our classes at school are not, if it'll focus, maybe not, are not nut-free. It goes by class at our school. So my kids are not in nut-free classes this year, but just FYI to anyone out there. They have other flavors that are also nut-free, like a shortbread that has like ABCs on them, and then a iced oatmeal. We have more extra toasty Cheez-Its. I bought these last week in my haul and Cohen was obsessed. He absolutely loved them, so I got the family size this time. I thought I would get some chicken in a biscuit cracker because I don't know if the kids have honestly tried these before and these were one of my favorites when I was a kid, so I ordered those. More of the Flavor Blasted Goldfish. Anderson's favorite is just the extra cheddar Flavor Blasted Goldfish. I got more of the Salsa Con Queso. Aniston requested this, she loves it. This is something new we haven't tried before. So Cohen and Aniston really like the Stretch Island, like I think it's called like fruit leather that I get at Costco. It can be kind of expensive. And when I was browsing the grocery order site last night, I saw these, I thought they'd be worth a shot. So it looks like you get 6 mixed berry and 6 strawberry. So we'll see how they like those. I got some Better Oats steel cut oats, maple and brown sugar. Chocolate chipped dipped granola bars. These are one of our absolute favorites. We've tried a lot of different brands that are like dipped granola bars and these are our favorite, so definitely don't sleep on Great Value. Like their stuff is really good. Just plain regular tortilla chips, barbecue chips. Once again, I tried to get the Honey Lay's barbecue chips that you guys like told me about and I can't, or maybe it was on TikTok, but I can't find them anywhere. They're sold out everywhere, so I tried ordering them again. They substitute them with regular Lay's, which is fine, but I was really wanting to try those, so I'm gonna have to hunt them down somewhere. I have 2 packets of taco seasoning. I wanted to order another flavored coffee for making my cold brew. I really liked that maple pecan Starbucks. It's just pretty spendy, so I thought I would give this Great Value one a try. It's supposed to be creme brulee, and I was trying to smell it through the package because with, let me see, I don't smell anything. I don't smell any flavor on this one. The one from Starbucks is just so fragrant, and like it smells amazing. It tastes amazing, so this might end up being kind of like a what, get what you pay for type thing because this was like under $4. Pretzels, this was another substitution. I just ordered a different brand, so they substituted them with these, which is totally fine. Here we have these super sliders. So we bought these to put on the bottom, the feet of our kitchen table chairs, because they like slide on the tile and make an awful noise. And then if you guys saw our IKEA desk hack that's posted before this, we also have these desks we put together from IKEA, and Chris wanted to put these on like the side. So if they do end up hitting the wall, it's not like marking up the wall, if that makes sense. So we're gonna use that for a couple different things. He picked these out and put them in the cart, and these were kind of expensive. Like my dad always had a bunch of these. So I'm sure my mom has a ton at her house, but these were $9, which I was kind of like, geez, $9? Like, okay. I got some mandarin oranges. These are the easy peel ones. I'm hoping they are also seedless, so crossing my fingers. Cohen's favorite, we finally got our hands on some rye chips. If you guys have not tried these, I highly recommend it. His favorite out of like the Gardetto snack mix is the rye chips. He always picks all of them out. So I started buying these a couple months ago and he's been obsessed. And the last several weeks I've tried to order them, they've been completely out. So I put two in my cart last night and we lucked out and we got two of them. We have some just regular pasta sauce, the tomato, basil, garlic. This stuff is really good. I like the Raos. I think that's how you pronounce it. It's like R-A-O-S. Pasta sauce, but that's like $6 or $7 a jar, and this is under $2. I'm using this for a recipe that I do in the crock pot for stuffed peppers, and so I just went ahead and got this, the cheaper stuff. Aniston loves cocktail sauce. We have some popcorn shrimp still in the freezer from Sam's Club, so I grabbed some more cocktail sauce for her because we have been out. Two cans of no-fat refried beans. The green chili and lime are my favorite. I can't find the jalapeno ones anymore, so that's a bummer. And then I just got four cans of no-salt added black beans, soy sauce. Back here we have two sweet onions, one red pepper, one red onion, and then this is cilantro, probably the smallest bunch of cilantro I've ever seen. I could probably eat all that cilantro in one sitting. I know that cilantro, you either love it or hate it, and I love it. Love it, love it, love it. Here we have yogurt-covered raisins and vanilla. This was actually a substitution. I ordered the Great Value brand, and we got the Sun Made instead. A loaf of bread for the kids. This is a loaf of bread for me and Chris. This stuff on Weight Watchers is only 1 point per slice. Love this stuff. It's really good. Hamburger buns. I didn't mean to order these. I gotta look. I swear I ordered hot dog buns because I ordered hot dogs. So I got hamburger buns instead. I'm sure we'll use them for something. I'm trying to think if I have in the freezer. I know I have some chili lime burgers from Trader Joe's, but I don't think I have any other burgers. So I'm gonna have to get some ground turkey or ground beef or some burger patties or something so we can put these to use, or maybe I'll toss them in the freezer. Lighthouse Jalapeno Ranch, love that stuff. More sugar-free coffee creamer. I went with Italian sweet cream this week. I've been kind of alternating between this and hazelnut. I really like sugar-free peppermint mocha and coconut cream, but those are extremely hard to find at my Walmart. So maybe if I venture out for some Honey Lay's barbecue chips, I can grab some other flavors of coffee creamer. Shredded mozzarella. I got these mini, so my kids like little sub sandwiches. They all love them. And these little mini, I thought these were so cute. So they're mini King's Hawaiian sub rolls, and they love the Hawaiian sweet rolls. And I thought these were so cute. Like, look how small they are. It's really just like two kind of like little rolls together. So these are the perfect size, especially to go in their lunch boxes, their bento boxes. So I grabbed these. They were pricey. It was like $4 almost for six of these. So there's other brands out there that are a lot cheaper. Usually when I do homemade like sub sandwiches, I just do like hoagie rolls, which are like under $3 usually, but I thought we'd splurge and give these a shot. I got 3 pounds of ground turkey. I know I've mentioned this a lot before, but I usually check the price. Most of the time, the 3 pound tray is cheaper, but sometimes they'll have like a single package of ground turkey like in 1 pound increments on sale, and it ends up being cheaper to purchase it that way. I double checked last night and it is not. It would have been like 12 something to purchase 3 pounds of ground turkey if I would have bought them individually, and this was like $10.67. So I saved money and did this. I could have waited until I made my way to Costco or Sam's to try to find some ground turkey, but my Costco is out of ground turkey like all the time. It's really hard to find there. So I was afraid if I went there, I wouldn't find it. Sam's Club, I don't usually have a problem finding it there, and it's a much better deal. It's like $10 or $11 for 5 pounds. Same brand, same 93% lean. Like, highly recommend checking your Sam's Club if you have one and you guys eat ground turkey. Shredded sharp cheddar cheese, more Velveeta slices. I grabbed Jackson just a little bag of Takis. He loves Takis. Light sour cream. Here we have bell peppers. So I wanted four to make the stuffed peppers, and I once again, I usually get like a lot of my produce at Costco or Sam's. Bell peppers are a really great deal at either of those stores, but I didn't know when I would be going. So I just needed 4 bell peppers for my recipe. So then I just purchased a single one so I would have 4. Here we have grape tomatoes. I did 2 packages of these. These are one of my favorite snacks. I just wash them and eat them straight out of the fridge. Strawberries, Roma tomatoes, bananas. We have a mini seedless watermelon and a cantaloupe. Shredded lettuce. We're gonna do tacos or burrito bowls this week. The kids will probably do tacos. I'm on this massive burrito bowl kick. Let me show you guys what I've been using really quick, really off topic. But if you watched the other day, here it is, my Trader Joe's haul, it was a mini one. This stuff is phenomenal. If you like spicy, highly recommend this stuff. It's extremely spicy. Not like too spicy, like you can't handle it, but you don't have to add hot sauce. Like way spicier than I expected, even though people told me that. It is so good. I'll have to be honest, I'm not a huge fan of cauliflower. And because you cook this on the stovetop in a little bit of olive oil or butter, it kind of crisps it up. And I can't tell the difference between this or regular rice. And I love to make a burrito bowl out of this. I add some grilled chicken that I either marinate, or if I'm trying to do something quick and easy for lunch or like a baseball night, I'll add this Tyson blackened chicken. This stuff is good, but also spicy. And then I just add whatever toppings I like on a burrito. I do lettuce, tomato, onion, cilantro, anything you like on a burrito. And then I add a little bit of sour cream and that guacamole I get at Trader Joe's, and it is phenomenal, like so good. Sugar snap peas, I'm obsessed with these lately too. This is one of my favorite snacks. We have regular milk, chocolate milk, hot dogs, because I thought I ordered hot dog buns, but apparently I did hamburger buns instead. When the kids are home, Jackson likes for a quick lunch, he'll just make a hot dog. And it's convenient during baseball season because they can have a hot dog as they're like going out the door to practice or whatever. And Jackson's been having friends over lately. So it's nice to just have kind of like snack food like this on hand, because preteen boys, they eat a ton. We have some smoked turkey kielbasa. This is something I like to do for a quick and easy dinner. I will put this either in the oven and do like a sheet pan type meal with it, or I will do it on the stovetop. But I usually slice up fresh bell peppers, onions, and like some sausage, and then we either serve it with rice or like just eat it as like it is by itself. That would be really good with, I'm gonna try it this time. It's already opened, but this is the, let me do this so you guys can see the package. The fire roasted bell peppers and onions from Trader Joe's. I'm gonna make it with this time, and then add extra onion to it and maybe some extra bell pepper, because I believe I still have 1 or 2 bell peppers in the fridge. What else was I gonna say? Oh, you can add any kind of veggies to that too. I'm also going to add mushrooms to this and possibly some zucchini, because I do have zucchini that needs to be used. I got myself some LaCroix. I love this cranberry, the Raz cranberry flavor, and I'm the only one in my family who likes this, so this is all for me. I don't have to share. And then for like Chris and Jackson, I got the cherry limeade. They love this stuff. Aniston and Cohen are not necessarily a fan of this, so that's just mainly for Chris and Jackson. So here is our grocery order for the week. Like I said, I had hopes of making it to Sam's or Costco tomorrow, but I'm gonna help my mom with some last minute errands. So most likely that will come the beginning of next week, like Monday or Tuesday. So keep an eye out for one of those hauls. I hope you guys are all having a fantastic week and everyone is staying safe and healthy. Bye, guys.